We've arrived in Tripoli and we're starting to get a little bit of a better sense of how this all works. Our contacts are telling us that essentially there are auctions 1 to 2 times a month and that there is one happening within the next few hours. So we're going to try and head out of town and see if we can at least get some sort of sense of how it works, where it is, and how this all plays out. We've been waiting the last few hours just to receive word as to whether the auction has started. We now understand that there are 2 separate auctions going on in this town that we're in and in a town only 20, 30 minutes away. And it looks like we will be able to go in and witness how this all happens.
يعني بقدر نستمر النزام؟
لا خلاص
هو كم
مثلا؟ 12 مرة.
I'm speechless. I don't know how to put this into words. There were human beings auctioning off other human beings. And even though there didn't appear to be any weapons that we can see, these people were brought out from that room one by one. And the whole environment, the whole feel was one of duress. The utter casualness of that. I mean, when we walked in, there was clearly a lot of nervousness, a lot of suspicion, and people started covering their heads, but they still kept going. And they were referring to these human beings that they were selling as merchandise.
Today is Wednesday, November 15th, the year is 2017. People for sale, where lives are auctioned for $400. If you just watch that report, it talks about migrants being sold as slaves. Let me read some of this to you. Not a used car, a piece of land, or an item of furniture. This is from CNN's website. This is the actual, that report I just showed is from CNN, from this year. Not merchandise at all, but 2 human beings. One of the identified men being sold in a grainy cell phone footage obtained by CNN's Nigeria. He appears to be in his 20s and is wearing a pale shirt and sweatpants. He has been offered up for sale as one of a group of big, strong boys for farm work, according to the auctioneer, who remains off camera. Only his hand resting on the man's shoulder is visible in the brief clip. After seeing footage of this slave auction, CNN worked to verify its authenticity and traveled to Libya to investigate further. Carrying concealed cameras into the property outside the capital of Tripoli last month, we witnessed a dozen people go under the hammer in the space of 5 or 6 or 7 minutes. Does anybody need a digger? This is a digger, a big strong man, he'll dig, the salesperson dressed in camouflage gear says. What am I bid? I'm getting people to bid on the buyers raise their hands as the prices rise. $500, $550, $600, $650. But the minutes is all over, and the men, utterly resigned to their fate, are being handed over to their new masters. It is unbelievable. After the auction, we met 2 of the men who had been sold. They were so traumatized by what they'd been through that they could not speak, and so scared that they were suspicious of everyone they met. Each year, tens of thousands of people pour across Libya's borders. These refugees fleeing conflict or economic migrants in search of better opportunities in Europe. Most have sold everything they own to finance the journey through Libya to the coast and the gateway to the Mediterranean. But a recent clampdown by the Libyan coast guard means fewer boats are making it out to sea. leaving the strugglers with a backlog of would-be passengers on their hands. So the smugglers become masters. The migrants and refugees become slaves. So it's a long report here on CNN that talks about modern-day slavery. We thought it was over with, and it's still going on as we speak. And it's not just going on here. There are other parts of the country that also have a country, other nations around the world who continue to have this problem. Now, I thought this part was interesting, though. One of the detained migrants, a young man named Victory, says he was sold at a slave auction. Tired of the rampant corruption in Nigeria's Edo state, the 21-year-old fled home and spent a year and 4 months in his life savings trying to reach Europe. He made it as far as Libya, where he says he and other would-be migrants were being held in grim living conditions, deprived of food, abused and mistreated by their captors. If you look at most of the people here, if you check their bodies, you see the marks. They are beaten and mutilated. When his funds ran out, Victory was sold as a day laborer by his smugglers, who told him the profit made from the transaction. Would serve to reduce his debt. But after weeks of being forced to work, Victory was told the money he had been bought wasn't enough. He was returned to his smugglers only to be resold several more times. I remember recently, here in the United States, they just sentenced some people who were illegally smuggling people into the United States and doing something similar, and I believe they were using as sex slaves. And they ended up going to federal prison for a long time. So this isn't new. It's been around for years. All around the world, including in the United States. Well, this whole country was founded based on slavery. If slaves hadn't been borrowed from Africa to build this country, it wouldn't be in the condition that it is in right now. It is disappointing and sad that so many people of color end up in these positions around the world. We haven't changed anything. Everything remains the same. Well, we over in the United States are arguing about some of the most mutant, some of the crazy stuff. People are around the world are literally fighting for their lives. Every day I wake up, I put a smile on my face and I say, I'm going to have a great day. I'm going to laugh. I'm going to do something I want to do. I'm going to go see something. I'm going to drive a different way. I purposely drive a different way so I can just see different things. Life is about living and being happy and finding joy and happiness, because our lives could be so much worse. Could be so much more horrible. I'm in good health. I have no issues here. I take my blood pressure medicine, I'm fine. I remember my sister Jackie was so sick for years and years, it just broke my heart. But she couldn't get up and do the things that I was taking for granted every single day. You know what I mean? And it broke, really, really saddened me that my sister was going through that. And if I can go back in time with my sister, I wish there were some things that we could have done differently when she first started down that path. I wish things had been to do. But with age comes, as you mature, you grow older. My sister was probably dealing with that illness when I was in my 20s. I was in my 20s, or 30s. I'm old. Late 20s, early 30s. I find happiness and joy in everything I do every day. I get up and smile, laugh. Some days I'm not really in a good mood, but I get up. And I say, I'm up, I'm out the bed, I turn on some music, I get my day started, and I go out and enjoy life. You know, I make my favorite, this is tea, I've been drinking tea lately. I'm trying to switch things up. I do coffee in the morning, when I get up and go do cardio, and I do some tea in the afternoon. I don't drink sodas and all that type of stuff. I don't drink any of that type of stuff. I haven't had a Coca-Cola in so damn long. I tend to stay away from those types of things, so I'm just more of a tea or coffee drinker. I was saddened by this report. I saw it and It shocked me because at first when it came through, someone sent it to me, I thought this must be mine. I was assuming this was a link that somebody was using to get you to, you know, bait you in and all this stuff. So I thought, now I looked at it and it said CNN, so I clicked on the link and the more I sat there and watched it, the more I was shocked and appalled. This is real. These people are really being put into slavery in 2017. The guy was just talking about, it says here, he spent $1 million+ Nigerian Naira, or $22,780. He tells CNN from the detention center where he's waiting to be sent back to Nigeria. My mother went to a couple of villages borrowing money from different couriers to save my life. They were trying to get him someplace better. Trying to get him into Europe. You know, I meet a lot of Nigerians here in the United States. And I had no idea what was going on in Nigeria. I thought Nigeria, and I could be wrong, excuse my ignorance, but I thought Nigeria was a country that was prospering and doing well. Maybe certain parts, I don't know. I mean, I really need to learn more about Nigeria because I just assumed it was a country that was a modern day. I didn't think they fell into the third world category where people had to escape to someplace safer. But after reading this, I'm beginning to see, and I mean a lot of Nigerians here, a lot of them. While many of his friends from Nigeria have made it to Europe, Victory is resigned to return home empty-handed. I could not make it, but I thank God for the life of those that make it. I'm not happy. I go back and start back from square one. It's very painful, very painful. He made it, you know. Gosh, I wish you could see these pictures. I'm going to try to put some of these pictures and videos in this report. Because I want you all, sometimes we don't know what's going on around the world. As sometimes we sit here in America and we think our issues, which we do have some bad issues, but our issues are not as bad as some people in other countries are having it really, really rough and hard. I found this report to be just sad and tragic. I'm going to post the links to the video and to the report so you can see it. I wish it was something we could do. I really wish it was some way, somehow. I mean, I'm grateful CNN when he got this caught, when he went undercover and got this report. Now the question is, what can we do to end this practice? How can we end slavery in 2017? I'm going to answer to that one. But I'm going to put the links to the reports. There's another video I'm going to try to add to this report. I'd like to hear you all's thoughts. And if you know anything, educate me. If you're from Nigeria or if you're Nigerian, what are the issues going on there? Because I don't know. I mean, what are the problems going on in that country that people are fleeing from there? Because I thought in today's modern society that the nation, the country of Nigeria, which is a country right on the continent of Africa, I know y'all will correct me in a heartbeat. Africa ain't a country. I know Africa is a continent. Nigeria is a country in Africa. I am very aware of this. I think they've got that right. I'm pretty sure Nigeria is a country inside Africa. A country, I don't think it's a city. So it is a country. So I'm very curious to see what are the problems going on there. And I need to start reaching out to my Nigerian friends. I have a lot of Nigerian friends who sometimes there is a, they call me on the phone, but the dialect is, I can't quite, you have to forgive me. So we tend to text a lot. And if you have, I'm a busy person, so when these guys are contacting me and we're trying to communicate, it's kind of tough to talk on the phone. So most of the time in my car driving places, I try to talk to people instead of texting and driving. But sometimes there is but the accents are so bad, I can't understand what a lot of these guys, I mean, because for some reason these Africans are like Nigerians and Haitians, and they're drawn to me. And so for my videos, and I try to meet them and have great conversations if I can understand their dialect. If they, you know, that's about it. But no one has ever explained to me why they fled Nigeria. I just assumed they just came to the United States, they wanted to be here, and then we're probably going to go back home to Nigeria. I mean, I don't know. So I just assumed that they were, I'm thinking, you know, I've never visited the country of Africa, and I really want to put that on my bucket list to do. I really want to go to South Africa. I always go online looking at these places and looking at the fairs. There's a couple places I want to go in South Africa. There's a couple places in Africa, on the continent of Africa, that I would like to see at some point in time. And it's not expensive to go to those places, just the flights are so damn long. I'm like, it's a long ass damn flight. It's a damn plane forever. And I've never really been across the Atlantic Ocean. So it's about time for me to begin that journey and go there. Wish I can go there for Thanksgiving. I don't know what you all are doing for Thanksgiving, though. I'm trying to figure out what I'm going to do over here. I'm going to try to figure something out. I don't know if I'm going to do some, I don't know if I'm going to cook dinner here. I'll go over to somebody's house. If you have any Thanksgiving plans for me, let me know so I can get me an airline ticket and get the hell out of here. I would love to be in Miami for Thanksgiving. But I don't think that's going to happen unless I go by myself because I don't know anybody else. Earl's going to be going home with his family for Thanksgiving. I could stay here with my family, but I'm really not feeling that. How am I getting? I don't know. I wish I could drive down to Miami and do some fun. Who knows? Anyway, I would love to hear you all's thoughts about today's video. I'm just curious to know what you all, what your thoughts are, and what do you think about what the problem. So I look forward to reading you all's comments. Check out the videos. Check out the link. Go read the story. Do some research and just try to educate me on what's going on in Nigeria because I don't know. If you like my videos, click like, share them with family members and friends. Today is Wednesday, November 15th. The year is 2017. I hope that you are out there doing something productive with your life because that's what I've been doing all day, something productive. I got up this morning I get up every morning about 6 o'clock. Jump out of bed, get dressed, run to the gym, do my morning cardio, and I have abdominal work. I'm trying to get these abs together down here. I would like at some point for I'm going to get my abs the way I want them. I got the rest of my body the way I want it. I want abs and legs. That's my goal. To get them where I'm going to be happy with. But I'm grateful that I can get in my car in the morning time, safely drive down the street, with a cup of coffee headed to the gym, put on my favorite music, get on an elliptical machine, enjoy life. Because sometimes things could be much worse. And when you look at stories, tragic stories like this slavery auction, which is appalling and sickening, it makes you wonder what kind of world we live in. Who would do this? What type of people are these? I'm not a religious person. I don't believe in demons and evil spirits and all this mess. These are just evil people. We're on earth with people who are just, some people are not good. They're just evil, nasty people. They're not demons or spirits. I don't believe in any of that nonsense. There's some people and it's unfortunate, but this world has been like this forever. You would think in 2017 things would be getting better for people around the world, but I see it's not. You would think in 2017 things would be getting better for us right here in the United States, but it isn't. It's like we're going backwards. Anyway, but enough of that. If you like my videos, click like. I'm out of here. Go out and enjoy your day. See you later.